How's it going? As you can see, I'm looking a little better. I've had my second spinal injection out of a total of seven. And instead of prolotherapy, they're using some hormone variant like testosterone and some other stuff. So if I grow a beard, I'll show you. Joking. Anyways, I'm doing really well. I'm up out of bed. I'm up and around. And you will not believe what I did today. I was taking our littlest dog, Wendy, that you've seen in a previous video, for a walk. Here comes a snake. I mean, it was huge to me. So I pulled Wendy away and I tied her on the fence and I went and grabbed a shovel and I went and smacked it on the head, I don't know how many times. And it wasn't the flathead shovel, it was the spade-like shovel. And so I whacked it and whacked it. I figured if it was smaller, I would have let it go, but this sucker was big. And so it wasn't dying, it wasn't dying. So I shoved the shovel into the ground with my foot while the tail was wagging all over the place. And I went and got the flat shovel and stuck that in and cut its head off. Well, I thought, I've been watching these survival shows on Discovery. So I thought I'd be brave and say, you know what? This has a really pretty skin. I wonder how you can skin a snake. Totally not me. The city girl wanting to, but it was an experience. I wanted to do this. So cut off his head, and I know that the head can still bite after, I think, up to an hour. So I took the head into the shovel with the stick, and I took the body in the shovel, and I brought it, and I let it bleed for a bit. Oh, no, this sounds so gross. If you have a weak stomach, you're going to have to turn this off. Anyways, I let it bleed for a little bit, put the head on top of a fence post. I'm going to show my boys. They're going to think I'm crazy. Anyways, I then, after it bled a little bit, I put it in my sink and I put it in cold water.
Okay, hey guys, just wanted to show you the snake that I caught and killed, and now I'm gonna skin it. I've never done it before, but we'll see. He's still moving. Look, his head's gone. I chopped it off, but his body is still moving.
I looked on the internet and I had my laptop in the kitchen, right? And so it shows you how to skin a snake. And you take the scissors and you cut on the belly. And so I'm like, okay, here we go. And I put all this newspaper on my island. And so I did all these instructions. It was nasty and gross, but it was neat. I could see the organs. And I like to see how things work, not like I like to kill animals. It was just really interesting to me, and because I've gutted fish before, so once a long time ago. So it's kind of like that. So my husband comes home. He said, "What are you doing?" Now this thing was still wiggling, so I went and tried to cut off the head area to make sure it was still moving and still moving. And as I was cutting it was still moving, and I felt so bad. Will go, "Oh my gosh, you killed a snake." Yeah. I know it, I know it, but this sucker was big and I've got chickens. I need to make sure that they're safe. So if it was small, I would have let it go. They eat rodents and all that, but I don't want to risk my children getting bit and myself getting bit and my animals getting bit, because I do live out in the country. So anyways, long story short, I did all the instructions. I pulled the skin off and gutted it outside. And because my husband's done that with doves, where he's went dove hunting. Dove hunting? Yeah, little bitty birds. Anyways, took the boys out to do that. Anyways, so I gutted it all out and everything, and I got the skin off, and then I put the snake meat in a Ziploc bag and put it in the freezer, because I don't know if I really want to cook it and eat it. But I'm saving it because my hillbilly husband has had squirrel before. So I'm going to ask him if there's a way to cook it, and I'm going to be brave and just do it. Because how many times can you say in your life, that you've killed and skinned a live snake and kept its skin? And I don't know. It sounds weird, but it's kind of like a neat accomplishment, kind of like Nature Girl. It was really, really exciting, and I probably don't look my best. I just took a shower, get all that fishy smell off me. But we measured it to be more than 4 feet long, and that's not including the part of the head that I cut off and part of the tail that I cut off. Anyways, I'm doing great. You can see I got a sunburn. I'm getting up and out, and I'm feeling better, and this is only with two treatments. Each time I go down to Charleston to have treatments, he injects me about, let's see, this time was 16 injections from mid-spine down to past my butt. And I'm not going to show you pictures because it's terrible. I'm bruised all over, but I'm doing really good. So I'm hoping to return to YouTube. There's just so much going on. But I just want to update you guys on that. And I'm doing great. My kids are doing great. Hubby's doing great. So that's it. So I'll talk to you later, guys. Love you. Bye.